In the previous segment, we concluded that we need a precise definition for the probabilities of momentum that we could observe when measuring a particle in a given quantum state. Indeed, you could ask this question for any possible observable. We will cover the general case later in our postulates, but in the case of momentum, there is a very natural way to go about this, and this will indeed make the general case much more accessible. And we will also directly uncover another important phenomenon. So our premise was that a state of a fixed momentum is a momentum eigenstate. Now it is a mathematical fact that any physical wave function can be written as a superposition of these states. That could be a sum over just a few components, but in the most general case, this is an integral over all possible momenta, where we denote the amplitudes of the different components as psi tilde of p. In general, this is some complex valued function. Incidentally, that this is possible has much to do with some of the conditions on our wave functions that we mentioned earlier, such as their continuity and the boundary conditions. On the mathematical side, these integrals with complex exponential factors are known as Fourier transformations, and there is a very general theory about them, driven both by their important place in mathematics. They are part of what is called functional analysis, as well as because of their applications, which cover many other areas of physics and engineering, even biology and finance, often when one wants to analyze complex dynamical systems. In this course, we make use of the central result, both the most basic as well as the most powerful one, namely that there is a very beautiful general expression to invert this relation and determine the function psi tilde. This looks very much like the original integral itself, just with the roles of x and p interchanged and a complex conjugation. Now, mathematically, psi tilde is the Fourier transform of psi, but physically, we will call it the momentum wave function. And the reason is the following. By taking the absolute value squared, we obtain the probability density for momentum. To see that this is a natural definition, think of the case of just a few, perhaps only two, plane wave components. What we do here is just to look at their relative intensities to determine how likely it is to then find the particle with the corresponding momentum. So while the probability density in position was obtained by the intensity of the wave in space, we just do the same here, but in terms of the intensities of these plane waves. As a matter of fact, we can deepen this analogy further. Note that even though it may look a bit artificial, we can rewrite the normal position wave function as a sum of all the position eigenstates, or as an integral. These are just the delta functions, and as I promised, we're only ever going to need one feature of them and only use it to deepen our understanding. We do not need it in actual calculations. But according to this one defining feature, namely that it extracts the value of a function at x0 when placed into an integral, we can write the following identity. Here, the wave function itself reappears on the right-hand side with a different interpretation, namely as the amplitude in front of the eigenstates. So now this is where psi tilde of p also appears in relation to the momentum eigenstates, and hence we really have unified our definitions. And from here, it is indeed just a small step to write down a general prescription for all possible observables. Okay, so I mentioned that we can use this probability density to directly uncover a new phenomenon. For this, we work this out for the energy eigenstates of the particle in the box. We first work out the momentum wave function by applying the general formula, so multiply the state by the complex conjugate of the momentum eigenstate. This complex conjugation really just puts a minus sign into the exponent, and then we integrate over all space. But again, the integrand is only finite between the walls. This integral can be done exactly. For instance, you can apply Euler's identity to write the sign in terms of exponentials, combine products of exponentials by the standard rule, and then integrate. The expressions given here all apply also for complex numbers. The result looks a bit simpler when we identify the expression of Pn, what one naively might have thought of as a quantized value of momentum. We then square the result to get the probability density for momentum. One can check that it is automatically normalized, another convenient feature of the Fourier transformation. When we plot this as a function of p, we see that it indeed has maxima near pn, but with a spread, which I indicate here as delta p. And when you look at the mathematical expression, the width of this peak traces back to the sine function. And looking into the argument, you can read off how this width scales. It is of the order of h bar divided by L. So we now see that we also get some sort of diffraction pattern in momentum. And this is reflected by a spread in momentum, an uncertainty in its value. And our expressions show that this uncertainty increases when we reduce the size of the region L. So we finally have come back to our original motivation to look at this problem, namely to see what happens when we force a particle into a finite region in space instead of letting it propagate freely. Overall, what we found are two important effects: that energy becomes quantized, meaning that only very specific values are allowed, and that momentum becomes undetermined, inversely proportional to the degree by which position has become more determined. Even more fundamentally, knowing the position wave function psi of x was all we needed to work out the momentum wave function psi tilde of p. So these quantities are strictly related. We will later quantify this exactly in terms of Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. But before we draw too many conclusions from just a single example, let us have a look at some other ones. Indeed, energy is not necessarily quantized when a particle can escape to infinity, and such settings also help us to deepen our intuition about the role of momentum. What's more, we also missed something really important, an effect called tunneling.